what other components used in this drone? Is GPS module good enough? Can I fly in the sub-250 category with this drone? What batteries can I use? If you are searching for the best compact FPV drone, you probably have a lot of questions. In this video, I am going to answer all the questions I mentioned and even more. I will share my honest opinion about this drone and its performance. This is not a sponsored review, I bought this drone for myself. Without further ado, let's jump right into the box. Here we have the drone itself, with two battery straps and the DJI O4 Pro. The packaging holding the drone clearly indicates the motor rotation directions, a clever solution for quickly confirming the default setup. Usage instructions covering basic safety rules, initial setup steps, first flight recommendations, configuration of external receivers, and how to control the drone with the DJI FPV remote controller. Two sets of propellers. Additional screws. A set of camera mounts for DJI O3 and analog cameras. Screws for the propellers. And a couple of stickers. In this section, I will walk you through the drone's main components and share my first-hand experience with them. Camera. It features the DJI O4 Pro transmission system. Camera protection. It includes aluminum alloy side plates to protect the camera. I haven't seen how well they perform in a real crash, but I hope they will reduce the risk of damaging the camera lenses. GPS. It has a 10th generation chip mounted at the front to minimize interference and ensure fast, reliable satellite acquisition. Based on my experience, the GPS works very well. It usually locks the home point in my location in about 10 to 45 seconds. I've seen it connect to over 20 satellites, which provides precise positioning for the drone. Motors. It's equipped with 1505 4000 kV motors. For a 3-inch quad, the power output is excellent. Flight controller stack. It features a 40 amps high performance stack. Power input. It uses an XT30 battery connector mounted on the top of the frame. DJI O4 Pro transmission module and external ELRS module. Dual DJI O4 Pro antennas and ELRS antenna. Battery compatibility. It's compatible with 4S batteries with a recommended capacity ranging from 650 up to 1100 mAh. Design and durability. It has a lightweight design with a takeoff weight under 250 grams. The frame also features replaceable arms, which is a huge benefit if you plan on doing a lot of freestyle. I have three TE 250mAh batteries, which fit perfectly. With this, you can get about 5 minutes of freestyle flight, and if you are just cruising around, you can expect 6 to 8 minutes of flight time. And here is how the drone looks with the batteries attached. The drone weighs about 179 grams, including external ELRS module, one battery strap and the props. The strap itself weighs about 3 grams. with a full-size TETO 850mAh battery, version 1 with 95C discharge rate, the drone weighs about 274 grams. With the version 5 that offers 150C discharge rate, the drone weighs about 276 grams. With 850mAh flat pack, it should be closer to 255 grams. Also, add a couple of extra grams for ND filter, if you plan on using one. If you need to stay in the sub-250 category, you will need to choose a smaller battery. 650 or 720mAh batteries should work fine. But always check the exact battery specifications to ensure you do not exceed the category weight limit. Okay, enough specifications. Let's test it. This is the first flight on that day, and the GPS currently shows 14 satellites. Every subsequent flight acquires the home point almost instantly on power-up, with a significant number of connected satellites. Later I will show you the footage from other flights on that day, and you will see how many satellites the drone managed to connect to. After the first takeoff, the direction to the home point did not work correctly, but now, after a couple of maneuvers, everything is good. I am performing a series of simple freestyle tricks to check how the drone reacts to my inputs. I like the hang time in the air, the power and weight of the drone are enough to have rapid punch and inertia. This is amazing, the drone is so small but very capable. On my first flight with this drone, there was very strong wind. I thought the footage would be impossible to use, but to my surprise it was quite stable. It turned out that the drone has enough power and weight to resist even strong wind. Later I got fully stable footage with help of gyroflow. Let me know in the comments below if you would like to see another video where the drone is tested in windy conditions. With maximum throttle, the drone drains the battery like crazy, but it flies like a rocket. I easily reached 164 km/h. Looking at the results of this test, I would suggest that you choose a battery with high discharge rate, if you plan to push this drone to its limits. With this drone, you can easily fly cinematically. It has good wind resistance, features a DJI O4 Pro camera, and is based on the dead cat frame. This kind of frame allows you to keep propellers out of the camera view. Just make sure your rates allow you to make the smooth movements required for this type of flying. That was the first flight. The total flight time was 5 minutes. Next, let's quickly look at the flight times of other flights that day. Another freestyle flight, 5 minutes and 30 seconds. Flight where I did not push the drone to its limits and it was just cruising around. 6 minutes, but the battery still has energy for about 1 minute of flight in the same style. Now let's check whether the GPS rescue safety feature works out of the box. The feature is now enabled. The drone is gaining altitude and starts moving towards the designated home point. Upon reaching the home point, the drone begins descent. At this stage, I took control of the drone and continued my flight. It looks like it works properly. Great job, DeepSpace! There are 5 things I love about this drone and 1 thing I wish they did differently. What I love. The drone has amazing freestyle capabilities. It's compatible with the DJI O4 Pro. Its camera mount allows you to adjust the camera angle to suit your needs. It features great GPS. And it has an ideal size that allows me to take this drone with me almost everywhere. Now, one thing I hope they will improve in future models. I wish they made it more efficient for longer flight time. Thank you so much for watching. If this video was helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more content like this in the future. I'll see you in the next one.